I checked this out already, didn't I? I seem to be having flashbacks. Diglett's Tunnel. No, I haven't checked this out yet. Wonder why I'm having flashbacks. Deja vu moment. But I came in here and it didn't look familiar. Diglett's Tunnel, finds Zubat. It's true, they've infested everything. Forget Mount Moon. This is insane. Alright, yeah, we'll just keep going. What's in here? Oh, hello. Hmm? Oh, Ryan, was it? Wasn't it? This cave really is something, you know? It's overflowing with these Pokemon called Diglett, and they're getting really out of hand. Mediocre trainers can't even get through. So how's your island challenge going? Let me see which crystals you've earned. Oh hey, since you're here on Akala, have you made it to our dimensional research lab yet? Traveling about for your island challenge is about more than just trials, you know? Have a look at it while you're at it. This is where we're going to come to progress the plot. Gotcha. Let's go to that dimensional research lab thing, apparently, that we have to go to or something. Hi there. Akala Island has three captains. They each specialize in a different type of Pokemon. Water, fire, and grass. Which makes it really interesting because the first trial that we did, the one over on Mele Mele Island, was normal. So we did normal, then we did water, fire, and grass. So we have, like, the four basic types of Pokemon. You've got your trio of grass, fire, water, which are, you know, the triangle attack pattern, you know, because water is super effective on fire, and fire is super effective on grass, and grass is super effective on water. And then you've got normal, which is the neutral one that's, you know, null on all four of that quadrilogy, I guess you could say. On top of that, the first Kahuna was fighting, the second, which is super effective against normal, which I don't think actually has anything to do with it, but the second Kahuna is rock, from what we just heard not that long ago, from Kukui at the end of the last episode, that Olivia is the rock-type trainer. And so, like, fighting is super effective on rock. So, like, I'm actually trying to piece together what types we're going to be up against in this game. I see Lily there. Can I get around this without activating a cutscene? I can. Hi there. Wait a sec. How do I get to Paniola Town again? Was it by going down Route 4, or, yes, it is. You having trouble there? Sorry, but my Stoutland is a real thorough kind and likes to uncover every last stone. Yeah, this guy again. So we can't go across there to wherever that leads. That looks like someone's, like, mansion. Alright. Go, Nebby! You splash! It's like, what are you talking about? I was just acting like I was Ryan. You always seem to end up getting hurt, Nebby. So I never really liked Pokemon trainers or thought that I would want to be one myself. But when I see Ryan and How, so that's why she doesn't like Pokemon battles. It's like they've thrown open some door that I always thought was closed. They stride straight through it into the future. It seems so amazing somehow. Cosmog noticed us. Oh, Ryan, hello. I feel like it's been a while since we last met. Have you been hanging out here in Heia Heia for the entire time I've been running around the island? There's a laboratory here that studies the dimensions, did you know? And the professor is waiting to meet you. How were your trials? It must be quite trying to do three in a row. I mean, I just kind of went bang, 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 and kind of got them all through, you know, it was no problem. Goodness, really? It wasn't any trouble for you to tackle all three of Akala Island's trials? I suppose that explains it. The reason you look so content and understood by Steenie there, I mean. Her name is Sue. Out to the Dimensional Research Lab, zzzp. Though the dimensions of my decks are perfect. Ha! The strange creature was sucked into the Zygarde cube. So they've got, like, you know, a thing here. I have a sneeze coming. Ah! Ow, that was loud. And it hurt, and it, wow, forceful. Oh my goodness. Oh, there's a little path back here to pick up. A big mushroom. Okay. Sure. Why not? Hello. You're going to the Dimensional Research Lab, aren't you? Anyone could tell that. After all, there's nothing else upstairs. Dimensional research, huh? That reminds me of something I heard about some rare Pokemon that can use rings to teleport itself through space. Ah, yes, I've heard of this Pokemon. In fact, in one of my past lives, Saying it like that makes it seem like Pokemon games happen, like, many, many years between each other. But, you know, we, not that long ago, actually, it was like, what, 2 months ago we had another Hoopa event or something? That I actually showed on the channel or whatever? It was, actually, no, that was last month, wasn't it? Wasn't that October? I don't even remember. Alright, let's go up here. Okay, which floor would you like to go to? 3F! Leave! The elevator doesn't even stop on the second floor. But how do I get to the second floor? You don't! Hey there, honey! Honey? Oh, hi! This here's Professor Burnett. She runs the Dimensional Research Lab, yeah! And she's also my wife! What?! Wait. Professor Kukui is hitched? Damn, she's mighty fab. You are fine, girl. You're Ryan, right? Lily told me about you. She said you were She said you were the reliable sort. 3 months ago, I found Lily lying on a beach. Cosmog in her bag was also unconscious. Hmm? No how today? How? He's out doing his own thing. But he'll be the real deal someday. He could even become a Kuhana. I said Kuhana instead of Kahuna, just like old Hala before him. You really think so? Whoa! Well, yeah, I really do. Good to see you again, How. It's been a while since I last saw you. Anyhow, I brought Ryan here because I wanted you to tell him about some of the mysterious phenomena here in Alola. I'd be happy to. The mysteries of Alola, huh? Then you've got to mean the Ultra Wormhole. It's extremely rare, but sometimes a hole opens in the sky over Alola. It appears that this rift leads to a different and unknown dimension. The reason that people think there may be a mysterious dimension is because of the legends of fearsome Pokemon appearing from the Ultra Wormhole. Fearsome Pokemon appearing from the Ultra Wormhole. Okay. It's very weak as proof, but I can't ignore it. There is also plenty of evidence already in the Pokédex for the existence of different dimensions, right? Fearsome Pokemon? Even normal wild Pokemon sometimes attack people, right? But the Pokemon that appeared from the Ultra Wormhole went way beyond that. They were called Ultra Beasts, and they were feared. If the stories are to be believed, the guardian deities of the islands fought desperately against them. But like I said, it's all legends and folktales. It's hard to know how much is true. Well, knowing this is Pokemon, it's probably all true. In some aspect. But I would be very happy if I could somehow unravel the mysteries of the Ultra Wormhole by studying the dimensional's disturbances. We've recorded several known relationships between Pokemon and different dimensions in books. You can find them on the bookshelf in this lab. Is that so? What does the professor think? We've got nothing better to do than read things? Read things and what? And talk to folks? Hi, Cosmog. Oh, you progress the plot, don't you? You want to know what happened 3 months ago? Well, based on the cutscene I saw at the beginning of the game, I can kind of guess what happened. But I guess the play is like our character doesn't actually know. Well, I wanted to learn more about Nebby. I mean, about Cosmog. So I decided to come speak to Professor Burnett. But I got lost along the way and ended up wandering about until I collapsed on the shore. She listened to my story, staying up all night to hear it all. And then she even got her husband, Professor Kukui, to lend me his loft to stay in. And she told him to help me investigate Nebby's origins too. Professor Burnett has been so kind, and she's still helping me try to find a way to get Nebby back to its home. To its own home. I like combine the words. She's been like a real mother to me. Really now. Hello, Magnemite. Mag! Bronzong, it brought rains by opening portals to another world. It was revered as a bringer of plentiful harvests. Huh. Really? Giratina! Now this is a Pokemon we know a lot about. I mean, you know. Not like we did that Pokemon Platinum Let's Play last year or anything. This Pokemon is said to live in a world on the reverse side of ours, where common knowledge is distorted and strange. Also, potentially, Giratina is the Pokemon of gravity, not of the antimatter. Palkia, its total control over the boundaries of space enable it to transport itself to faraway places or even other dimensions. Got anything about Dialga in here? Come on, let's be real here. You need some stuff about Dialga if you're going to include Palkia and Giratina. Is there nothing else for me? There are many writings about the interdream zone that exists between reality and dreams. Huh. Hello, Slowpoke. I bet they're using you to try to figure out the dream stuff or whatever. Let's see here. Professor Burnett was previously studying a dimensional space called the interdream zone. There was a man named Moan who years ago published his theory about the ultra wormholes. If you use the Versus Recorder, you can not only rewatch old Link battles you had with others, but you can even hold mock battles against the teams captured in the battle video. That's why battle videos are the best! Oh, that's cool! If you use battle teams, you can not only register 6 special teams from your boxes, you can even register the same Pokemon to more than one battle team at a time. Damn! That's a feature I wished 6th Gen had. TBH. That's why battle teams are the best. I'm off to check out Diglett's Tunnel next. It's a whole cave made by Pokemon, right? Alright, let's go talk to Burnett. We've recorded several known relationships between Pokemon in different dimensions in books. You can find them on the bookshelf in this lab. Okay, yeah, which bookshelf? Oh, I guess I just have to come over here. How about that, Ryan? If Ultra Beasts are really out there, I wonder what kinds of moves they can use. You finished all 3 of Akala's trials, woo! And now comes the big match against Olivia, the island Kahuna. It's the biggest and baddest trial of them all here on Akala, the Grand Trial. Good luck. Olivia's house is past Diglett's Tunnel. It's in Konikoni City. But watch out for Team Skull. I still have some things I want to talk to Professor Burnett about, so I'll stay here. I'm off to check out Diglett's Tunnel next. It's a whole cave. He just said that when I talked to him. Diglett's Tunnel, what a lucky bunch. I want to have a place named after me, too. Zzt. I mean, we could name a place after you, Rotom. It wouldn't be that hard. We can name a department store after you, and you can just prank the customers by hopping into all the appliances. Oh? What's going on here? What was that just now? It looked like a crack in the sky? I must be tired or something. Hey, Ryan. So you've made it through all 3 Captain's Trials, yeah? Then you should go meet Kahuna Olivia. She lives in the town past Diglett's Tunnel. Diglett's Tunnel is, let's see. From here, it's kind of near the PMC. Are we abbreviating Pokemon Center as PMC now? Is Pocket Monster Center? Because, like, in past games, we just called it the PC. Like, I was questioning that the last time House said that, and I didn't verbally put it out there, but I'm wondering that now. It's easy to walk right past it, though, so keep your eyes peeled. I actually walked into it already. Now it's Malasada time for me! So, question is this guy and his, Stoutland still over here? Yes, they are. I was turning around. Stop talking. I'm gonna hop on my Tauros and let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, 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 go. Oh, hi. So how's your island challenge going? Let's see which crystals you've earned. Oh, look at you, Ryan. Nice work. I see you've even passed Mallow's trial. It's about time you had some fun with me. The Diglett have settled down too. If you are as strong as you appear, you should be able to make it through this cave. At the other end of it, you'll find Coney Coney City. That's where my shop is. I'll see you there. Are you just going to hang out here while I, you know... If we can get through this tunnel, we'll be just steps away from Coney Coney City, big boy. Zip. You just say the same thing? Yeah. All right. Then I guess we'll go through. I did take a peek and see... just what we will be able to find around here. Let's go ahead and use this max repel. Might as well, right? It's there to be used. I did go ahead and take a peek at what we would be able to find in here, and it turns out that it's, more of the same. It's Zubats and Diglets. That's pretty much all. And they're still gonna be able to run into us, of course. So here's the question. Do they change how they work, or are they just higher level than us? They're the same level as us. All right, so it'll at least block a number of them, hopefully. Hopefully their variable level is from below us to probably the same as us. Worker Frank would like to battle. He's got one Pokemon. It's probably a Machop. Oh, it's a Diglett. I haven't actually tried fighting a Diglett with Sue yet, or Steenie, I have no idea what its name is. I know what its evolution's name is, I know how to say that, but its name I have no idea. Magnitude 5, that won't do too much. That's a decent powered magnitude, I guess, but we do resist it, so it's not going to do much at all. Wow. If it would have gotten magnitude 9 or 10, I would have been scared, but magnitude... 5, it's nothing. Mud Slap won't do much, but it will drop our accuracy. Yeah, there it goes. Let's try a Razor Leaf, even though that is inaccurate. It did about the same as Magical Leaf. Then again, yeah, our special attack is actually higher right now because base stats are weird. This evolution line actually has pretty weird, The way their base stats go as it evolves is kind of weird. Well, that's fine. The same is true for my Pokemon, but your Pokemon, incredible! I'm really excited with how the team is coming together, though. Oh, I can't wait to see it just become its final forms and stuff like that, you know? I should really just run back to the Pokemon Center since we're really close to the entrance, but... oh well. I feel like there's gotta be something hidden over here. That's the wrong thing. This is what I want. Really? There's nothing over here? Huh. Figured it would be a perfect spot to hide something. Okay. Let's see here. I don't really have too much to say because it is just a cavern. A simple cavern we can get through. Overall, though, it looks like we're only running into level 22s. So, then again, that is only the second encounter. So I guess we'll find out. You're not a trainer? Looks like a fellow trainer who can use Z-Power in battle. Let's find out whose full force strength is the fullest. I have to beat all the trainers in the tunnel, then I can talk to you. Of course. Let's see here. There's a staircase here. I could use Tauros here, though. All right, Tauros. Lead me to Firestone. So if I wanted a Flareon, now I can get one. Hello? Phew. With Olivia in charge, we finally managed to make some headway against those Diglett. Oh, Alola. We're members of the Aether Foundation. We work to support Pokemon conservation. It seems like Team Skull was responsible for the Diglett in this cave getting so riled up and bringing them all up to the surface. Oh, Team Skull is this group of troublemakers, you see. They seem to delight in interfering with trainers and their Pokemon. Diglett normally live in elaborate systems of underground tunnels that take years to dig out. We're here to ensure that they return to their tunnels and let people pass through here without having to fight so many Pokemon. Some of the Diglett are still stuck on or near the surface, though, so be careful. Thanks for letting me know. I like your little fanny pack doodads. With your little Aether Foundation symbol on them. I did put her up a rappel, but of course. Level 22? What level are you, Diglett? Let me know. I suppose I should fight it so that I actually gain experience points. That would probably be smart. Because I can always just cut them out, right? Unless, of course, I just talk over them and make some stupid commentary. Look at it sucker punching me. How dare! Oh, right. This is why we don't fight wild Pokemon in this game. This shit oh, never mind. She didn't get any help. Magical Leaf. Alright, we can continue on now. I just need to get Sue up to level 23, and then we won't have to worry about all the encounters. What's back here? Oh, no. It's coming after me. That rappel wore off. Let me get a super rappel up. Switch over to the super rappel. I do kind of wish that it could, like, see if you are have other rappels in your bag. We need the ability to push stuff to get through here. There is a trainer here. Which we're going to run into a wild Pokemon first. Let me heal up before this guy sees me. Restore. Super potion. There we go. 49 points. Only wasted 11 hit points off of that super potion. Hi there. Dig a hole. Dig a hole. Dig a dig a dig a hole. Dig a hole. Dig a dig a dig a hole. You're challenged by Worker Jeff. Jeffa Dong Ham. He has a Rock and Rolla. Heck yes. Love me some Rock and Rolla. Oh man. Let's go ahead and Magical Leaf. I'll just Magical Leaf again to make sure I don't miss. There we go. Goodbye, Rock and Rolla. You have a Mudbray. Well, I'll stay out here and just Magical Leaf away. Magical Leaf! Stamina! Stomp! I wish I knew Stomp, then I would evolve. It's true, though. I was gonna say, I should probably try using Razor Leaf, but actually I'm raising its physical defense, even though I'm hitting it with a special attack. That's gonna do a little bit too much. Okay. I'm gonna survive, though. I will survive! There you go, Sue. Oh, and you didn't level up. Let's heal you up because we're sure to run into another wild Pokemon, which I probably will end up running away from, even though I probably should fight it. Back it up. There you go. All right, let's continue on through the cave. Not worry about the running around encounters. There's a glowy thing here. Strange creature was sucked into the Zygarde cube. Well, good. I hope it was. work through brute force doesn't go well. No, no, it doesn't. Not usually, anyway. Sometimes it might, but usually that's a no. I took my glasses off. I can't read his name. What does it say? Vaclav. What is that name's origin? Oh, a Machop. Look at that. I'm not super effective against it. Alright, Sue. Let's show this thing who's boss. That did more damage than I would like it to have done. I'm going to go ahead and switch into, I guess, Sindri. I'm going to switch into Sindri. Let's go. Oh man, Sindri's going to end up with level 31. Doesn't matter if Sindri's speed drops because it's already... Oh, it's faster than a Machop, apparently. Okay. Suger to level 23! Hooray! Power is beyond what I imagined. Your power is beyond what I imagined. What's down here? Oh, hello. Ah, no way. Just when things were starting to heat up, yo! I get surrounded by Diglett and beat up, yo. And since when can Diglett use beat up? I'm so mad that now I want to beat up on some fools. Don't be mad because you were the fool who was dumb enough to be here right now. Ryan! Ow. I was wondering who you were playing around with without me, and it's Team Skull. You want some? That's how we say hello. Nice knowing you, punks. Girl doesn't even get to talk. Fine, let's do it. Pocket monster style. Yeah, double battle this. Heck yes. One each though, come on. You guys can do better than that. A Fomantis and a Salandit though. Of course you're gonna send out your Pikachu. Why wouldn't you? Alright, so I'm gonna switch Pokemon actually. I wanna switch to Andrea, but I might have to switch to Aki? I'm gonna switch to Andrea. Yeah, we've got Rock Tomb on Andrea, it's fine. Alright, let's go ahead and drop a Rock Tomb on Salandit. 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 That's a weird name. Drop this Rock Tomb. There you go! Now we can team up on this thing. Okay, so since I totally don't need Howl's help, my curiosity has been piqued. I don't need Howl's help here, though. Oh, I thought it was a free-for-all! Nope, he does have his old team. Alright, that's all I was wondering, was if he only brought one Pokemon with him. I'll go ahead and use Flail on Fomantis. Yeah, no, Pluck is so much more useful. That was such a great idea. Everybody should do that. There we go. Are we headed to the grave, yo? Will your bones be bare? Will our bones be laid bare, yo? The gloom that enfolds us like fog. We can't seem to shake it off. Yo, step off. Enough with the beating up, yo. We may not be trying to take over the world or nothing, but we're still hard as bone out here. See ya on the flip side. Man, Ryan, when I fight with you, it's like even my Pokemon feel more at ease. Except for my Pikachu, because you fucking punched it in the face. You really are some kind of trainer. That's it. I've got to give you something. A max ether. Of all things you could have given me. Alright. Now I'm gonna go have some more fun with those Diglett. See ya! Said no one ever. Which one is Olivia's shop? What did you say? Why doesn't my map have this programmed in? Yeah, why doesn't your map have that programmed in? But welcome to Route 9. Short and sweet. To the point. Route 9 police station, don't fight, don't meet anyone's eyes. Okay. Oh, I see what you mean. Gonna make me fight the cops, I get it. Oh, what? If it's not urgent, could you come back later? Sorry, I'm on my break right now. Okay. If you ever get lost, just check the town map. I depend on it regularly. Okay, then. Alright, I can totally run around this guy, which I'm going to actually go ahead and do because I need to run into this town and heal. Oh, a cutscene. Well, I guess, yeah, every time I run into a new town, it kind of does this, doesn't it? Did I just end up in Chinatown? Dude, a Probo Pass. What is that deli bird up to? Well, who knows? I want to go and run into the Pokemon Center. Because I need to heal up my Pokemon. That's why I'm here. Right. That's what the Pokemon Center is for. And actually, I can deposit this Eevee in the PC. I don't need this Eevee to be traveling with me. So we'll go in the box 3. Click the Eevee and drag it in. We've caught quite the number of Pokemon, though. We'll say that much. What happens to a Pokemon's consciousness when it's put into the PC box? To be conscious, you must be awake and aware of the world around you, wouldn't you say? But are Pokemon awake when they are in the PC box, or are they sleeping? I wish to go into a PC box to find out. That's, like, really deep thought. Holy crap. Everything that we experience in our lives is connected to our Pokemon. That is what Kahuna Hala teaches us. Hello there. Hey you, you've got a Rotom Dex, haven't you? Then I've got the perfect job for you. What do you say? Will you take me up on it? Sure. I'm an employee of a place called the Aether Foundation. We're doing a survey right now of a Pokemon called Passimian, which lives in the lush jungle. You are in luck, my friend. I caught one of those. It's registered in my Rotom Dex. But I've had no luck finding any of them, and I'm in a real tough spot now. Absolutely. Here, check it out. You caught a Passimian? Ah, then will you show me your Dex? So that's it. There are things here that we couldn't figure out from the data the Foundation had collected. Thanks a lot. Here, this is for you. I'm glad that one happened by accident. Now we know a bit more about Passimian, about how Passimian live out in nature. Thanks for helping out the Aether Foundation's efforts. Alright, what's new now that I have Mallow's trial completed? I can buy Ultra Balls already, and they're only 800? What? Hyper Potions are more expensive in this game, though, but they restore 120? Wait a minute, what? Hyper Potions restore 120? Instead of 200? Wow. Okay. That's a change. They finally realized after 20 years that hyper potions restore too much, so people never bought max or max potions. Like a Stuffle. You're just as cute as mine. That cute Pokemon might look like it's here to help out or something, but don't be fooled. It's here to snag leftovers from the cafe. And it's a lot stronger than you might think. Truth. My Poliwhirl. I can't make up my mind whether I should evolve it into a Poliwrath or a Politoed. Please trade it for your Zubat. Wait, so you can't make up your mind, so you're going to trade it to me. Actually, to hell with it. Zubat is like the easiest Pokemon to find. Let's do this. Sure, let's do an in-game trade. We haven't done any yet. Let's go ahead and do it. We'll trade Fatbat away. Whoopee! I'm super happy! I'll be nice to your Zubat, so please be nice to my Poliwhirl. Take good care of Whirly. Poliwhirl's data will be added to the Pokedex. There you go, 150, Poliwhirl. Registered. The tadpole Pokemon. Although it can live on land, it prefers to stay in the water, where it has fewer natural enemies. That Poliwhirl has a Water EMZ, so please use Water-type Z power. So she couldn't make up which to evolve it into, so she gave it away. Huh. Crazy. She crazy! I do want to show all of the in-game trades at one point. It's level 22. That's not bad, actually, if you wanted to just add it to your party right away. Came in at a naughty nature. So, it's actually, yeah. I would make this a Poliwrath, personally. However, I want to basically use all new Pokemon, whether they're Alolan forms or actually brand new Pokemon. I didn't stop off at the, let's go to the cafe. I always like to see what's up with the cafe here. Got anything new here? It's 0 o'clock. It actually is, yeah. We'll Moo Moo Milk it, I guess, because nothing's new. Here you are, one Moo Moo Milk just for you. This Moo Moo Milk is made with milk I just collected. Allow it to roll gently across your tongue as you drink it. Stuff about battle videos. This is a popular snack in Lumia City in the Kalos region. Lumios Galay. Gelee? Gelee? Whatever it is. I'm always saying words wrong, so... And we get some Pokebeans! It's always worth stopping there for either more Pokebeans or, you know, a free biscuit thing. Hi there! Yo, I'm an herb seller! Oh, you're a hippie! I'm self-taught, but I sell good quality herbs. What you got, then? Heal powder, energy root, revival herb... I'm less than interested. Clothing shop! Look, it's Harambe! Okay, I'll stop. It's a Pikachu! Look how small Pikachu is. I wonder if a bluish-purple outfit would be better to set off my Pikachu's coloring. You know what? If you leave an outfit that someone is wearing, or if you like an outfit that someone is wearing in Festival Plaza, they can have apparel items delivered straight to you. That's cool. There's no traditional looking clothes here that go well with my Oranguru, are there? Maybe I should just choose some items that will be useful in battle instead. Okay. Welcome. But what you got here? I think it's time to update my style, you know? Sandy gas tank. Nice. We haven't run into any sandy gas yet, actually. Whoops. The, Lepity. Want to get a good look at these shirts. Necktie tee. Nice. Can I get that inverted? Because that would be nice. Charum tee. Sporty tank. Let's see here. Okay, so I'm actually going to do the necktie tee. Let's buy one of those. Let's see here. What would go nice with that? None of these, actually. Low top sneakers, sporty sneakers. The sporty sneakers actually look pretty good. For the most part, anyway. Ooh, get the black ones. I like that. Let's see here. I could get pink shoes. Yeah, no, I'm not about beige. Not about beige shoes. I'll buy the black ones, though. I like those, because black goes with basically everything. Finally buy a new backpack. They're all scout backpacks, but that's fine with me. I don't understand why they don't... Nobody has blue. Can I just get blue? That's a nice cap, actually. Kind of like the cap. I just kind of wish I could get it, you know, in a matching color. Tempting. The legendary cap is tempting. But it doesn't match the t-shirt. Ugh. Versus the cap. Like, I'm still wearing the default cap. I'm gonna get the pink one. Forget it. There's gotta be other shorts I can get that semi-match. Maybe these kinda do? I don't know. I'm having difficulties here. Why are the pockets black? That's kinda silly. I'll go with these. We'll do a full outfit overhaul. I just don't think I'll get a backpack. I just will not get a backpack. Alright, we are decked out again. We're still gonna run around with the blue or with the brown eyes, though. We can also get a haircut here, which they probably have different styles. So maybe it's finally time for that. No. I want to have the fur around my Hypno's neck trimmed and cleaned up. But oh, my silly Hypno, she's a clumsy one and she always puts the stylist right to sleep. Because she doesn't want it trimmed. Alright, cut, I think. Oh, you know what? You know what? Let's check out the colors and the cuts. See if there's different for both. Right, right, right. I know that Pokemon, it's great, isn't it? I gotta love a Staynee. Now then, what kind of look are you looking for? It's all the same. I was kind of hoping. I should have saved the game. I should have. I was thinking about it, and I didn't. Ugh. Let's see how ridiculous this looks. What color? All the same colors? It's all the same colors. That looks ridiculous with white skin. I'm sorry, but I think it looks ridiculous. Also, I'm not wearing a hat. I don't wear a hat with this. Just a cut, please. Because it's all the same stuff, and that's a little upsetting. It took my hat off. Why would they do that? I can run around without the hat, though. I mean, I could. That's a possibility. I want to change clothes. I want to put my hat back on. Check mirror. Look at that. All right, let's change these. Look at my beautiful hat. Yeah, no, I don't have, okay. I don't have like any ridiculous colors. Okay, let's get our asses out of here. Or our mutual ass. I don't know. What's going on here? Wouldn't you like some lovely smelling incense? Spelling? Smelling incense. Look at all these incenses. I can buy them all. Lomi Lomi is a style of massage we practice here in Alola. How about a treatment for your Pokemon? It will make them feel more friendly towards you. Sure. There we go. I think this session was a good start. It's feeling a bit more friendly toward you already, I'd say. Thanks. I don't really understand these foreign these foreign goods, but they are pretty fun to look at. And I had no trouble on understanding the stones and fossils in Miss Olivia's shop up there. Welcome to the Technical Machine Shop. Hey, TMs, I like those. Bulk Up, Venoshock, Double Team, Low Sweep, Shadow Claw, Dragon Tail. These are all really good TMs. Sir, you have some grand TMs. Let me see if I have some junk to sell you. Effectively junk. You could probably sell it for more money than you're going to pay me for it, but, you know, like this Big Pearl. And this Stardust. I was like, wait, why is there a thing there? That's all I've got to sell. Okay. Let's see here. What can I afford now? Two of them. I want Shadow Claw and Dragon Tail the most, I think. Shadow Claw, yes. And Dragon Tail. I don't know if any of my team members can learn those two moves, but we're gonna find out. I assume at least Shadow Claw. Nature Power Sky Drop. Wow. All right, we got one for Shadow Claw and none for Dragon Tail. Shadow Claw is good enough for me because we can finally get rid of Lick. Not that Lick's a bad move. I mean, we've got Bite, which is better than the Lick. Would you rather a cat bite you or lick you? I think lick me. Well, now it's going to claw at you. Do you want to know if your Pokemon feel friendly toward you or not? Sure. Let's talk about... Well, we know Chewy does. Let's talk about Aki. Then I'll have a look at your Torracat there, shall I? My, it feels incredibly close to you. Nothing makes it happier than being with you. Alright, so we found the chick that tells us if we maxed out the happiness. Hi there. Good to see you. Let's see, what's this place? Ah, is this the place, the thing, and the stuff, and the table for one today? No, I'm not eating. I think I'm again soon. I eat until I'm fit to burst. Then get a bit of a workout in with some Pokemon battles. But I guess my Pokemon are the ones working. Is that why they're the only ones staying slim? Oh my. Now I made them angry at each other. Ha! Alola is home to a lot of new dishes. Since the foods of so many different cultures and regions all get mixed together here. That's great, and I love copying great things. Just like I copy an opponent's best move. Ha! It's okay to get sick of doing something. It's just a chance to try something new. But I never get sick of the lineup they have here at this restaurant. You've got to eat to grow strong, right? And so if I just keep making enough delicious food, everyone will eat it and get stronger. That's true. Can't go there. I can go upstairs. What's upstairs? somebody's living quarters. I'm just kind of walking in here. Captain Kiawe gave me this Magmar. He could see that I have the potential to become a real Iron Chef if I, with his fellow's fire. And I wouldn't mind having a better matchup with that grass type using Mallow, you know? I get it. So if you can't beat Mallow at cooking, at least you can beat her in a Pokemon battle. Wait, that looked like I could. Okay, never mind. Now, there's a loft over here. There's a faint smell of spices, sauces, and other fragrant things. Just, you know, I climb up in everybody's bed. It's fine. I can't climb in that one. Never mind. Okay. Let's stay here. Why not? I'm sorry, but you don't have enough. Crap. I'm broke. I'm broke. Wow, Olivia's store is actually way more chic than I had expected. I know she's the Island Kahuna and all, but she seems like such a normal person, you know? You're looking good. Thanks. What's this? Konikoni City, a town that welcomes the sea breeze. Opposite of the town, you can find Memorial Hill and the Ruins of Life. You can feel the presence of the ancient kings of Alola there. Cool. Are the ancient kings of Alola the Tapu? Like, the guardian deities? But honey, I heard you can fish up some rather rare finds if you cast your line over piles of rocks that have bubbles erupting from them. Oh, that hubby of mine. He's good at fishing up pearls and heart scales, though, right? But he doesn't have a lick of luck when it comes to Pokemon. Neither do I. Don't worry, dude. Hello? It's a stranger. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you, mister? Are you one of my sissy's friends? It's so relaxing, as though you're wrapped in the fresh scent of the sea breeze. This game. No. I wanted to get into the top one, but I guess I can't. Okay. I like this town. It's kind of neat, actually. There's a dock here. Somebody's boat's here. Anything hiding out for me, though? No, it doesn't look like it. Okay. Ooh, I see a green shiny over there. Kahuna Olivia is a rock-type Pokemon user. It's pretty amazing when you think about it. Rock-types have plenty of weaknesses. She's definitely something to be able to boast of such strength even when she uses such a disadvantageous type. There we go. Let's see. I'm just trying to see if there's anything hiding out around here. What's back here, then? I was going to say, that looks like a load zone. There's three Pikachu standing there. Are these yours? Look at all these Pikachu. It's like a Pikachu splash. I'm so tickled pink that I think I'll give you this Pikaneum Z. You obtained a Pikaneum Z. Why don't you come talk to me if you teach your Pokemon the move Volt Tackle? Remember, a Pikachu with Z power is sure to be a happy Pikachu. Okay. That's a thing. Eviolite. That's ironic. I guess I can't go up to the lighthouse. Okay. Let's make sure to grab this here. No, not the Pikachu. Don't talk to the Pikachu. Get the strange creature sucked into the Zygarde cube. Oh, Sina wants to talk to you. Zzt. You've collected 10% so far. If you'd like to know what that number means, please come to the Aether Base on Route 16 on Ula Ula Island. You're getting warmer. Bon chance. Bon chance. That, whatever. Lighthouse Point, the point that has a lighthouse. How distinct. Pikachu. Pika pika pee. So many Pikachu. Alright, well, I'm sure that all the excitement to happen with Kahuna Olivia is going to take up some time, and we're already running pretty long on this session. So let's go ahead and end off today's episode here. So as always, guys, if you enjoyed it, make sure you leave a like down below. Dislike it if you thought it sucked. Leave a comment down below if you feel so obligated to do so. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And until the next one, guys, my name is Flares. Thank you so much for checking out the video, and I will see you guys right back here for the next episode of Let's Play Pokemon Sun!